chance to email the venues and ask them if I could be opening an act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked a video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it, it turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I wanna be recognized, I wanna be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let him hate it.
Nobody help when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day. For all the time, nobody helped me. Said I ball on you. Man, like every day. For all the time, you say it, man, I ball. Man, like every day. Until the day I pass.
On the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium, just north of downtown Tampa. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys.
Good work, boy. Let's go.
Carry for Leonard Fournette, and not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Now Brady. This will be caught by Brown. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage, and now third and 11 coming up. Shotgun now for Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. 5 yards, and that means they come up short as they're going to have to punt here on the opening drive. This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 22. Prescott off play action. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a third and three. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Short yardage, Prescott. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. The drive stays alive, a third down gain of 8. So Dak with a completion there, really showing no ill effects from that injury a season ago. Yeah, what do you think your keys are defensively trying to stop Mr. Prescott?
Well, I think any defensive coordinator will tell you, stop his running game first, because he is at his best off of play action. Let all of your linebackers come up to the line of scrimmage after the fake to the running back, and that allows him room and space to make a decision downfield. So take away the run, and that allows you to drop into coverage and blanket the field.
A first down carry by Elliott. Runs over him. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
Zone now. Prescott. Al Wright completes it to Jarwin. Touchdown! Blake Jarwin, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Cowboys are on the board here first in the season opener.
Well, we know someone just added to his touchdown passing total, but all he did was get the ball out quickly to his tight end and let him take care of business the rest of the way.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They went 3 and out on their first drive of the new season. Not an ideal beginning as they start drive number 2, 1st and 10. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. Second and 10. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Throwing left side. He's got Gronk. Complete. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down. Now Brady, got a man, it's Brown, and he will have the 1st down, but he winds up paying for it pretty good. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
And already down 7-0 after the touchdown a minute ago, so a 3 and out here would not be ideal for them. Nice job finding his receiver there, and they get the 1st down.
Check, 42's the mic. Let's go defense.
Throwing on 1st down is Brady. Flushed out right. And that one is incomplete. And it also concludes quarter number 1. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Here's a give to Fournette. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on 3rd down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And on 3rd down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Fakes the give to Fournette. Now Brady. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A big gain of 28 as the drive continues.
good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
From the 30 on second down, Brady. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
What a dimension this man brings to this defense. He had his mind set there that he was going to get in and make that tackle. He really flew to the football.
And when the ball gets swung out wide like that, sometimes it helps you as a defender because now the field gets cut down and you actually have the sideline. It's almost an extra tackler for you. You can locate your target quickly, and he was able to get over there and make the play.
He finds his man complete. It's Brown. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. They'll get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Into the red zone, it's Brady. Oh, it's complete. A diving grab there by Brown. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. It's because of catches like that. That's why he goes. Watch 18. 18's the mic.
Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Brady now to throw. On the screen, Bernard. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. But 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Here's Brady to throw. And that's going to be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
A big play if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal.
Check 50, check 50.
No, 66.
18, Mike, 18. Ricky, Ricky.
To throw is Brady. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, so a drive that spans all that time, and yet you may only come away with 3 points here.
Well, your defense, all right, they actually like these long drives. They get to rest over on the sidelines for a while. But when you're not finishing with points in terms of touchdowns, that's frustrating. They've got to figure out how to close out these long drives and get sixes instead of threes.
So the 3 points there, and CD, that helps him inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they'll get another. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Shotgun, a give to Elliott. And a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And the Bucs with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Now Prescott. He'll get this to Elliott. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And looking at this situation, Charles, you got more than a minute. You've got all three timeouts. Probably no need to play this safe.
So what you're saying is that we're doing a little bit of a mind meld here, aren't we? Because I'm thinking along the same lines as you. This amount of time, don't be compelled to play it too safe. This is a chance to get points on the board. Press it a little bit.
Especially since a touchdown here gets you the lead. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. Here's Brady. Open man left side is Gronkowski. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. To his running back Evans, and he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll kick it away for the second time. He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with a 7-3 lead, we'll see how aggressive they want to be. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. That catch good for only a couple.
So, CD, big changes for 2021. Of course, last year we had the expansion from 6 to 7 teams in each conference making the playoffs. This year, the headline, the addition of a 17th regular season game. What did you think when you heard the news that this was happening?
Well, my first thought, partner, was finally, because we've heard about a 17th game coming for a long time, and now here it is. So the beautiful part about all of it is that 17th game is going to be like these interdivision, interconference type games that are going to match up and play out over a four-year period, and that's kind of cool. And I was looking forward to seeing some of the matchups that were going to come out of that for that 17th game, and could that be the game that decides a bunch of division titles?
So we have reached halftime here in the Thursday night opener. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. But we'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. This one will come out to the 25 as Pollard is going to elect not to return it. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Hitting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
Dalton Schultz had one catch in 16 games in 2019 before producing 63 catches in 2020. I don't think it's hyperbole to say that he exceeded everyone's expectations, including his own.
They'll run on first down, Elliott. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And it looked like he got the feet down, did he? Yes, it's a catch. What a play that turns out to be. 36 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Play action now, Prescott. And he's going to go down here, a sack. They push him back to the 34. Shaquille Barrett able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Prescott over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
The Bucs with an extra defender now in the secondary here on third down. Throwing, Prescott. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And he missed it. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Well, close game, second half. You obviously hate to leave three out on the field.
Especially in a game like this when you know points are hard to come by. That was one of their best opportunities so far. and they come away with nothing.
The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession.
And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal.
42 to Mike, 42, 42 to Mike. Go, go, go. Jim, 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 Jim.
From the 41, Brady. Going for Evans, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off by Keanu Neal. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Prescott from the gun. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On 3rd down, it's Prescott. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for 4th down. To throw is Prescott. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. The Cowboys here unable to convert on 4th down. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
A few better down a score in the fourth quarter than Tom Brady. This is first and 10.
Now Bernard. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Play action. Now it's Brady. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down.
Micah Parsons
brings him down, and that's a play he's going to remember. The first sack of his NFL career. The sack backs him up, third and long. Tough challenge for Brady in the box. On play action, it's Brady. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now, standing just about on his own goal line. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And taken right on the 30. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. On play action, Prescott. Outright completes it to Jarwin.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock, and this is second and less than a yard. Off the play fake, Prescott. On the left side, Gallup's got it. A Cowboy first down there, Prescott to Gallup.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. The end result, 21 yards. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. He'll get it to the 23-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Now flags fly in, and one of the Cowboys looked like he got going a little early. They were looking good on second down, but now they're backed up 5 yards by the false start, and it's second and 8. Play fake. Here's Prescott. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the veteran Richard Sherman. And a very good return as he takes us all the way up to the 35-yard line.
And Richard Sherman uses his veteran savvy to come up with an interception there, and he still has plenty of ability out on the corner. And he's the NFL's active leader in interceptions. Moved on from the Niners after 3 seasons, but thriving with a new ball club, and that veteran know-how comes into play one more time.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Micah Parsons, the linebacker, in on the tackle.
This run defense has been pretty stout all game long. Now you're here in the fourth quarter. Just rely more on the passing attack?
I don't think you have any choice, and I don't think you have to dress it up at all either. Throughout the first 3 quarters, you're still trying to convince the defense that you may run the football. That's out the window right now. Protect. Let your quarterback operate and try and find some targets in the open field downfield.
And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Third down now, and those last 2 plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Now Brady. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Howard. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a gain of 16, first down Tampa Bay.
Heady on that one, huh? Getting out of bounds before the 2-minute warning. They get an extra timeout. Extra opportunity to move the ball downfield. Very smart football.
Fournette, a first down carry. And he will be stopped here for no gain, and that is going to take us to the two-minute warning. Not able to go anywhere that time. Second down. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Here's Brady to throw. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. Room here to run. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. Down Bernard, and he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
I like the call there, because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Back to throw, Brady getting it out wide here to Bernard, and he'll go down here at the 12 yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucks may have moved. A full start backs him up 5, first and 15. Now Brady. And this will be incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Second and 15. To throw is Brady. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. Play coming up here on this drive. This is third and a yard. Brady to throw. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Wow. How many people watching this one right here gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To throw, Prescott. Able to find Gallup. And he's got a first down as he's tackled inbounds at midfield. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now Prescott. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And a return stops at the 39-yard line.
Well, you knew you had to take some chances here with the clock winding down, needing a touchdown to win it, and that one might have just sealed their fate.
Yeah, and that's the nature of the two-minute drill. The offense trying to go downfield and make their plays. But defenses, they're sitting back watching everything that they do, but not too far back. They want to be in position to make a play on the ball, and that they did. When everyone was excited, the football was back.
It is just special. You could just feel it. It's so good to have the pigskin back out there. It'll be crisp fall weather before we know it.
You got that right, but I love the build up to it, right? All day long anticipating it. And then we got here and we saw a game, the first game of the year. Let's keep going.
So for the Buccaneers, they begin their Super Bowl defense with a victory here in the Thursday night opener. And they'll get the weekend off now as they get a little extra time to prepare to face the Atlanta.